Hey y'all, welcome to my channel. My name is Lore. This is part two of me rearranging or reorganizing my bookcase. And I started filming these clips at like midnight one night because you know when it's nighttime and you get that sudden urge to just rearrange your room? That was kind of what I was feeling. So I decided to move all of my Spanish books from my bookcase in the bedroom to the bookcase in the living room, and I just had to show the cover of this textbook thing because I think it's beautiful, and this book is amazing as well. I highly recommend it. And also my bookcase was very dusty. And then look at this beautiful artwork as well. It's just so beautiful, I couldn't not show it. But this is what my living room situation is looking like. The bookcase in there is a catch-all bookcase for me. I rarely, if ever, show it on my channel, but I wanted to take all of my picture books from the living room and put them in my bedroom because I just wanted them to be displayed on my real bookcase or bookshelves. This bottom row here is mostly like textbooks, cookbooks, things that, you know, you keep but you don't really plan on reading cover to cover, basically. And I just had to add all my Spanish textbooks to it because I thought that made the most sense. So enjoy me doing that, and if not, I have timestamps in the description so you can skip ahead to the, I like to call it the prettier bookcase. Interview with the Vampire my freshman year of high school, and I did not believe in annotating at that time, but there was this one iconic line that I had to annotate back then, and I still love it today. I needn't point out to you I have more wit to fare better in my little finger than you and your entire frame. That's an iconic comeback, and it takes the words out of my mouth. Alright y'all, so yesterday I showed you that I moved all of my Spanish books into my living room bookcase. Now the shelf that we're working with is, yeah, still a mess down here, but these two shelves, I'm still enjoying how they're looking. I probably will switch this one up though, just because, why not? And then I'm going to get started with removing all the books from down here. Thank you.
Okay, so I've taken all the stuff off. Just ignore the basket of clothes and all that stuff. That's not my stuff. And this is what it looks like on the ground. It's a lot. I don't even know where to begin. I have all my vinyl. I have some manga that I somehow need to fit on the manga shelves. I have a bunch of nonfiction. Then I have a bunch of different categories of fiction, not Burning Sweetgrass, that's part of the nonfiction. And then I have a bunch of children's books, fantasy, some more nonfiction, mostly like classics over here, and then like fantasy again. So I don't know what I'm going to do. My laptop is here because I'm playing music off of it. But I genuinely don't know what to do. Oh boy.
A lot of this video is just me playing around with all of the books and just trying to figure out where I want things to go because I honestly did not have a plan going into this, which is kind of obvious the more we watch, unfortunately. Okay, you guys, so I fixed that shelf. Do I love it? No, I can't say that I do. This is actually starting to drive me insane. This is why I have to take it two sections at a time because I'm starting to already just like lose steam and just be like, I don't know, overwhelmed, I guess. Thank you.
Okay, y'all, so this is Edgar and I's TBR cart. It's more like a catch-all cart. At the bottom, we have like arts and crafts. This middle shelf here is all of Edgar's stuff. I don't even know if he knows what he has here. This is my shelf. I love how I was so excited that there's room here, but really it's because I took all of this and I'm gonna put it here. So it's not even gonna be a TBR cart. Technically, I've read the majority of the things here. So now I'm just gonna transfer all that onto the top cart and let's see how we do it. These were a gift from Miss Rin Reed's. Shout out to her. They're very beautiful. Anyway, okay, let's focus. Alright, y'all, so I'm finally finished with rearranging my bookcase. We went from this all the way to this. I'm actually really happy with how it turned out. I love that I'm able to face out one of my editions of Frankenstein, and I have Zuko with his lightning next to the lightning there. Love that. Here I have history books, essentially. This shelf holds some classics, mostly gothic literature. Then we have just a bunch of vampire books at the end, as well as the Metamorphoses, because I don't know where to put it. And then here we have more classics, and then it kind of bleeds into literary fiction. Then we have romance, some more literary fiction. And then here I have room to grow because I'm trying to read more classics, and so this will all start moving this way. I just really wanted to put like all my visual books here in one place because I think they're amazing and deserve their own little area. Sir? I'm just kidding. I'm almost done. I also have room to grow here because the third book in this series is coming out this year, so I'm just keeping that space open for that book. Then we have fantasy, and then we have two Revolutionary War books that my boyfriend gifted me when we first got together. Currently, they're not on my TBR because I have no interest in reading them. They're more just like a decorative piece because they were antiques, you could say. And then at the end is A Mormon Mother, which is a fantastic book, and I loved it, and I have a first edition of it, which is really cool.
Alright, y'all, comment down below how you organize your bookshelves or bookcases, what have you. And thank you guys so much for watching. That's pretty much all I have to say.